The trick to building a successful business is to pick something that the market needs and build a great team. This is the second installment in my series that reviews Undercover Billionaire and brings the lessons that we learned inside of the show to you for the frizzle, for the free ball, as some say. Let's roll. All right, free people, this episode of Undercover Billionaire starts out with Glenn as he is trying to figure out what his business is gonna be. To help Glenn figure out exactly what business he should start, he went to a resource that is widely known but underutilized, and that resource is the Small Business Development Center, the SBDC. There is a Small Business Development Center in most communities in America. And the point of the organization is to help small business owners get on their feet and get businesses started in the community. Most people know about this resource, but do not utilize it enough. He talks about how the Small Business Development Center has a ton of free resources that can help you get lit and start moving on your way to success, on your way to your business. I want everyone to look up their Small Business Development Center and figure out if any of their resources or programs would help you in your time. So after Glenn goes over the SBDC and how you should be using it, he talks about how he used it specifically to help him research which business would be the right one for him. And this is something that you guys should all be paying attention to. What Glenn does is he asks the Small Business Development Center, what industries do you feel like would be smart for me to go into? Which businesses do you feel like would be good for the community and would be good for me as a person with low capital? He already had a few things in his mind, like beer, like coffee, but taking those things to the SBDC and having them research that topic, research these industries, made it that much more clear what he should do. All right, now that we've talked about the SBDC and what they can do for new entrepreneurs, let's talk more in depth about coming up with your business idea. Creating the right business is so important, especially for new entrepreneurs, because not every business idea is going to work for every stage of an entrepreneur. Every entrepreneur has different strengths and weaknesses, and different businesses complement or are hindered by those different strengths or weaknesses. You should be paying attention to those as you're coming up with your business, as you're coming up with your idea. And I'm gonna dig a little bit deeper right now. All right, specifically the three things that Glenn did in order to come up with his businesses are: one, looking at trends. He looked at trends within the local economy and within the country and looked at what industries were on the rise. Growth in an industry indicates a growth in demand for the product. The second thing that Glenn did in order to come up with his business was he networked with local entrepreneurs. He asked local entrepreneurs, okay, how did you get into what you're doing? What do you feel like are great businesses to start in this community? And he got some different ideas from people in the community, one of which he ended up landing on. And for the third thing that Glenn did in order to hone in on what his correct idea was or what the right business would be for him, is he kept his startup capital in mind. He understood that if he needed $100,000 to start the company, then he wasn't going to be starting the company. There are tons of entrepreneurs that, as their first venture, want to create something that costs a lot of money. Even I wish I had known this or seen this or analyzed this before jumping into SoHeart. A lot of people want to create apps these days. A lot of people want to create a massive piece of software or do something huge that they have never done before. Luckily, I've been building software for years, and so the largest price tag for the business, which was creating the software, I already could get for free because I was working in it already. But what I didn't understand was, even though I had experience in it, and even though I've been building products for years, there was a cost to my time. There was a cost to me being able to put time towards building the app. Even though I don't have to pay myself, even though I'm not gonna charge me, my time going into the app means time away from my 9-to-5, which means essentially I'm paying for it regardless. So I don't have to pay $100,000 in order to build my app, but I do need to pay $100,000-ish to be able to maintain the lifestyle that I had back when I had a six-figure salary. This is something I did not see at the time, and I wish I had known it, but as it is, I'm already in the game and ain't stopping now. Soheart is a train that ain't stopping no time soon. So let's go. All right, so now you've got your business thought of. You already know what you want to do. You already have your business in mind. What is the next step? Glenn Stern says specifically this: once you have a direction to head in, one of the most important things you can do is surround yourself with people who strengthen your weaknesses. The importance of a team. He says this because no one can do anything alone. I teased on this a bit in the last video. If you haven't seen it, I'm going to have a link to it below in the description. So, at this point, he's focusing on his team. And what he does immediately, first thing he does is he posts an ad online, posts a free ad online that says, I'm looking to build a team for a company that I want to build. Does anybody want to join? At this point, he had decided that brewing beer was going to be his million-dollar business idea. He came up with that, of course, with the SBDC and with his conversations with local entrepreneurs and with his startup capital needs and the growths of the different industries that he looked at. He came down to local or craft beer being what he wanted to nail in on. Because he was getting into the craft brewery business, he decided he needed to learn more about the industry. So what he did is he went to a local brewer and asked him everything he could about the business. As Glenn is trying to raise the startup capital that he needs to create his business, he had goals for himself, weekly goals. Everybody should have a max of 3 goals that they want to achieve within the year, and let those 3 goals break down into sub-goals, into goals that will, if you executed on them well, would lend themselves into achieving your larger goal. Once you have a team, you understand your direction, you've started to bring people onto the team, what you want to focus on is you want to make sure that you instill confidence. From day one, the team needs to understand that you believe in the vision of the company so much that they have no qualms, they have no doubts, no fears about whether or not you believe that the business is going to be successful. It doesn't take being a billionaire to instill confidence. From the beginning of the team's journey with Glenn, what they did was they worked on a sweat equity basis. He said, hey, this business can be your business. You can have a major part of this, but we aren't going to be paying. The business isn't formulated, and so therefore, the beginning few months of this is going to be a bunch of sweat with no pay. After which point, after we start to do well, we can then start to become paid, but this is not a paid opportunity. This is not a job. If you are not paying yourself from the business's revenue, then you should not be advertising to potential teammates that they're gonna be paid. Be upfront, let people know what it is, and let them work for the business. Let them work for what they want to keep. Let them hunt what they kill. Let them hunt what you kill. Let eat what you hunt. Let them know what you gonna do. Let them know. Let them know that it ain't no money yet, and let them know that they need to work for it if they're gonna have some cash. And that will help you weed out the people who are not on your team immediately. That's it for this episode, guys. If you haven't seen the first review I did on Undercover Billionaire, then I need you to check out this video that's gonna be up in the info card, and I will catch you next time. Be free.